champion. We're using a 10-point must-scoring system. A mandatory in-count. Three knockdowns in the round will not end the fight. That normal rule has been waived for this heavyweight championship fight. No saving by the bell. If a fighter is down, when the bell sounds, counting will continue. It's a 21-foot ring with a canvas like a mattress. Very soft. The Joe Frazier kind of canvas. He doesn't bounce. He's a slugger. Keeps coming at you like a tank. Foreman bounces some, and when he does, he'll sink. It won't be too good for him. In the background, I hear cheers. So Joe Frazier, the heavyweight champion of the world, age 29, has had 29 bouts. Unbeaten, 25 knockouts in his career. Only four men have gone the distance with Joe. Muhammad Ali, of course, in the never-to-be-forgotten bout of March 8, 1971. Oscar Bonavina twice. There's Joe Frazier coming down the aisle, hanging on to his manager, Yancey Durham, as he always does. That's the Joe Frazier habit. Joe hasn't been very happy with George Foreman's behavior. Joe says he's a guy who likes to be let alone, who respects other fighters. But Foreman has been expressing disrespect for Frazier, and Frazier has seemed openly edgy. Not an act, not the usual promotion. He wants to do away with Foreman quickly, if he can. Bonavina twice, I was saying. Ali once, and Scrap Iron Johnson once. They're the only ones who've gone the distance with Joe Frazier. As Joe gets into the ring, right, he'll be operating right above us. There's George Foreman. Oh, they've changed the corners on it, gentlemen and ladies. George Foreman will be in this corner. Originally, it had been set for George Foreman to be in the corner diagonally opposite us, but no, George will be right above us. You see Joe in that colorful attire. The white gown, in effect, with the gold, really, gleaming gold trim and belt. Joe Frazier came in at a surprising 214 pounds. 8.5 pounds more than he was the night he fought Muhammad Ali. George Foreman, for him, a most satisfactory 217.5. George, of course, being 3 inches plus taller than Joe, and George having some considerable reach advantage on Joe. The referee will be Arthur McCarty as the ring announcer Dwight Wiley begins to get ready to introduce the contestants. Arthur McCarty, who's refereed 21 championship fights in his career, including the Ali Frazier fight, generally considered the best referee in boxing in the United States. The judges, Phil Spano, veteran boxing judge from Philadelphia, and Jacques Minot of Jamaica. And all three will be scoring the fight. Again, the 10-point must scoring system per round. Well, they're trying to psych each other out as Arthur McCarty makes his announcement.
This contest for the heavyweight championship of the world will be governed by the rules of the Jamaican Boxing Court.
No fear in either man. There is no fear in George Foreman. He's grown enormously in his confidence of speech and presence, as well as in boxing. We're close to the start of round one. Any second now, and we may have an interesting evening. Frazier, quite understandably, the favorite. Foreman comes out punching with the right. Frazier in his usual style. Smoking is the way he puts it. His job to get inside. His best weapon, the left hook. Foreman is vulnerable to the hook. Oh, the crowd was misled when Joe fell back a little. There was a slip off balance. Historically, Frazier has not been a good first-round fighter. But historically, he has been a tremendous, tremendous fighter. A great champion. You saw the left hook land on Foreman. That's what he'll be working on all night. Foreman would like to keep punching and keep Frazier away from him with his punches. Joe's job to get inside. Steadily use that left hook. We're Foreman connected, as you saw. He's a big, strong boy. He likens this fight to the same kind of problem he faced. There's another left by George. He's getting into Frazier's head. We'll find out tonight how much the Ali fight took out of Frazier, if anything. And we'll find out tonight just how good George Foreman is in punching and in taking a punch. I think he hurt Joe Frazier. I think Joe is hurt. Angie Dundee, Ali's trainer, right next to me, is saying it. You may hear him. Down goes Frazier! Down goes Frazier! Down goes Frazier! The heavyweight champion is taking the mandatory eight count, and Foreman is as poised as can be in a neutral corner. He is as poised as can be. We have a minute left in this first round, and already this fight is proving out what some have expected. Oh, that left is getting in there. Underneath, Archie Moore is yelling to Foreman. We've got the excitement here that we look for. Frazier is dazed. He is getting hit again and again and again. The same head that was hit so often by Muhammad Ali. Frazier is dazed. You see the countdown for the first round. Foreman has not panicked. Foreman is going about his job. Foreman is all over Joe Frazier. Frazier is down again, and he may be. No, he is rising. He is game. He doesn't know where he is. The mandatory eight count. He doesn't know where he is. Now the round is about to end. Two knockdowns in the first round of Joe Frazier. Down again. No saving by the bell. He's up, and so the fight continues. Three knockdowns in the first round by George Foreman. The stool hasn't even been brought out yet for Frazier. What excitement. You're looking at Joe Frazier. Yancey Durham over. The crowd shocked, but the crowd here rooting for Foreman. Muhammad Ali was their hero. Now you're looking in slow motion. The right for the first knockdown. Clean as a whistle. Oh, what a first round. Well, back in Frazier's corner, as you look at them working over Joe, the ice pack at the back of the neck to restore the senses. Let's go to the slow-mo for the second knockdown, the right again. Clean as a whistle again. We're waiting for the start now of round two. There was no question about the first round. Three knockdowns. Now Joe is coming out. Adam wants to come back in a hurry. You'll not find a gamer man than Joe Frazier. Joe Frazier, who went down three times in the first round. A caution from Arthur Mercanic. Oh, he is all over Frazier again. He has Frazier in the corner. Frazier's knees buckled. He is down for the fourth time in the fight. George Foreman is doing to Joe Frazier what he did as a 19-year-old to a veteran Russian, a fellow named Iona Shapulin, in October of 1968 in the Mexico City Arena. A quick left from George. Another. Frazier is down for the fifth time in this fight. Fifth time. Three times in the first round, twice in the second. McCanny checks his senses, checks Frazier's senses. It's target practice for George Foreman. It is target practice. Frazier is ready to go again. Joe is standing. There he goes. Three times. Three times. The fight is stopped. No, it is not. It is not stopped. Angie Dundee is screaming, stop it. Bertie Pacheco, Ali's doctor, next to me. It is over. It is over. It is over in the second round. George Foreman is the heavyweight champion of the world. And I'm going up into that ring to talk to Joe Frazier, the loser, and to George Foreman, the winner, because Joe Frazier has been a great champion and deserves consideration. Yancey Durham hugging him. They're going crazy about George Foreman. I'll be back with Joe Frazier in a moment.